This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Dear students, there are large number of organic compounds, and these organic compounds behave differently from inorganic compounds. That is why we study organic chemistry separately. And in this session, I am going to discuss reasons for the existence of large number of organic compounds. The first reason is catenation. Catenation is derived from a Latin word catena, which means chain. The catenation is defined as the property of the element to form chains of identical atoms. And this catenation is observed in case of non-metals showing covalency of two or more. And we all know that covalency of carbon is 4. Carbon is tetravalent. Carbon atoms can form chains as small as 2 or 3 atoms, and carbon atoms can form chains of as long as thousands of atoms. Students, please note that these chains can form rings of different sizes. Chains and rings can have branches, can have cross links. For example, if I write this, this is the skeleton of 4 carbon atoms. I can do the branching in this manner. So, n number of possibilities are there. Now, let me tell you, this property of catenation actually depends upon the strength of the bond between the identical atoms. Strength of the bond. For example, carbon-carbon. This bond energy is 83 kilocalorie per mole. And if I compare with silicon, the bond enthalpy here is 54 kilocalorie per mole. For sulfur, it is 54 kilocalorie per mole. For phosphorus, this bond enthalpy is 50 kilocalorie per mole. For nitrogen, it is 39 kilocalorie per mole. For oxygen, it is 35 kilocalorie per mole. And now, on the basis of this data, we can conclude the tendency to form chains of identical atoms. Carbon greater than silicon, you can see. And silicon and sulfur almost same. So, I'll write almost same as sulfur. Greater than phosphorus, greater than nitrogen, greater than oxygen. The point is clear, the tendency to form the chains of identical atoms or tendency to show catenation property, this is in this order. You can see carbon is the maximum tendency to form chains of identical atoms. So, this is the first reason for the existence of large number of organic compounds. Now the second reason. Second reason is the ability of carbon to form covalent bonds with heteroatoms like oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, chlorine, etc. So second is ability to form covalent bond with heteroatoms, such as oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, chlorine, etc. This is the ability of carbon to form covalent bond. This is another reason for the existence of large number of compounds. And this can be explained with the help of data. The bond energy CH is 99 kilocalorie per mole. The bond energy CO is 87 kilocalorie per mole. The bond energy CN is 73 kilocalorie per mole. The bond energy CCl is 81 kilocalorie per mole. You can see here, on the basis of this data, we can say, yes, carbon has the ability to form a strong covalent bond with heteroatoms. My point is clear. Now, third reason for the existence of large number of organic compounds. Ability of carbon to form double or triple bonds with another carbon or with nitrogen or with oxygen, sulfur, etc. For example, C double bond C. And for triple, C triple bond C, C triple bond N. So carbon has the ability to form double or triple bonds with other carbon atoms, with nitrogen, with oxygen, etc. And this is the third reason for the existence of large number of organic compounds. Now the fourth reason is existence of structural and stereoisomers. Structural and stereoisomers. Structural isomers are the compounds having same molecular formula but different structures, like C2H6O. C2H6O, with this molecular formula, I can write two different compounds, CH3COCH3. This is known as ether, and I can write C2H5OH. This is known as alcohol. Now you can see the two isomers with the same molecular formula, two different organic compounds. Now stereoisomer. Here the formula is also same, but arrangement of atoms in the space is different. For example, if I take a butuene, I will write CH3, C double bond, CH3, HH. Another CH3 here. CH3 here, H here, H here. You can see the two have same molecular formula, same connectivity of atoms, but here the atoms are on the same side. Here, hydrogen atoms are on the opposite side. And that is why we are getting two isomers here. This is known as cis-butuene. And this is known as trans-butuene. And these are called geometrical isomers. So students, isomerism is greatly responsible for the existence of large number of organic compounds. This isomerism we will study later on in detail. Okay, so these are the different reasons for the existence of organic compound. In the next video lecture, I will tell you different types of carbon atoms and different types of hydrogen atoms possible in organic compounds. Thank you. This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Testprepadda.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprepadda.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.